Howdy all y'all, it's time for cake. I got something rather intricate in mind today. One of the things that can occupy a whole lot of time in the early stages of Botania, I've been noticing, is making runes. And we got kind of stuck in the middle of the whole making runes thing earlier because I didn't have all the ingredients I needed for a lot of them. But I've been out hunting, and I've been out in the nether, and actually lucked out and found another fortress not too far away just by following the z-axis and keep on digging till I found a big enough cave, and what do you know, there one was. They do tend to kind of be in rows. If you find another fortress and you go on the z-axis, you go north or south, you're probably going to find another nether fortress. Probably not that far away neither. Sometimes they're only like a couple hundred blocks apart from each other. Anyhow, what I was saying about runes and stuff. So, it's something that can take up a fair bit of time. And I was poking around at the solutions different folks have for Botania. And I ran across this fella named Riskable, who has a pretty awesome Let's Play channel, or it's more of a how to do stuff channel, to be honest. And yeah, I get that way too sometimes, but also, I mean, you watch me making all my mistakes too. But yeah, so what we're going to be doing today is we're going to be setting up a thing to automate rune production. But to do that, we're going to need to make some stuff. For starters, we're going to need to make us a couple new flowers. We're going to need us a Hopperhock, which is one of the best dang things in Botania, I have to say. It is kind of like a ender vacuum, if you've ever seen it from open blocks. It just picks up everything on the ground around it within a certain distance, and it puts it in an adjacent inventory, and you can hang a picture frame on that inventory and tell it you only want items in those picture frames to go in that inventory. Or you can tell it to put everything but that into that inventory. You can do a lot of things with them. And the other thing we're going to be making is a Daffomill. And a Daffomill is basically a fan. It'll blow stuff in a 5 foot wide lane, or 5 foot, five block wide lane, and I believe it's 5 blocks vertically as well, though I don't think I've ever tested it on the down mode, just on the up mode. So we're going to make us a couple flowers for starters, and then we're going to make a more complicated piece of equipment. So let me just get out, let's get out our book, and these are both functional flora, so there's our Daffomill, here's our Hopperhock. Let's start with the Hopperhock. So yeah, placing items frames on inventory specifies which items can or can't go into them. It's a flexible little beastie. So it's also going to require some runes. Now, I don't remember, we already do air, we got fire, we got water, we do not have air. That's right, we were missing some stuff for air. Well, I was hunting spiders in the Twilight Forest, which, let me tell you, is a nightmare place because every single wolf in there is an infernal. But, let's see, we needed carpet. That's what we were missing, was carpet. Okay, well, I'm pretty sure I've got carpet now. Well, I can make carpet anyway. Like I said, I've been hunting some spiders, and I do believe we needed a feather, and we can ditch this egg while we're here. Okay. Carpet, feather, one piece of string. Yep, we can do this thing. Easy peasy. No, that's not how we do it. Let's try... Huh. Oh, right, we gotta make it into two wool blocks first. That's what the problem is. Okay, and there we go, three pieces of carpet. So let's get on down here to our runic altar. Nope. Let's try that again. There we go. What else is in there? Is there... No, okay, they are even. Never mind. I was a little confused for a moment. There's our feather. one piece of string, and one piece of carpet. Okay, and now we're gonna grab a wand, which I don't have. Okay, let's get the wand out, and we're gonna need a piece of living rock too. So let's get that out. Yeah, you can see I've been busy. Went halfway through a diamond pick. I've been real busy. So this is what's bothersome. You try to make stuff with a runic altar, you gotta put stuff in it, you gotta wait for this thing to count down, then you gotta dump a piece of living rock on once you see the lightning. Come on, lightning. Any day now. Hello, lightning. There we go. And immediately, zap it with the wand of the forest. And that gets us our runes of air. I think I'm going to go ahead and make the rune of... We already got fire. What's the other one we're missing? Earth? Let me get that down here. Let's just knock this out. Let's just get this done. Rune of Earth. Stone, coal, mushroom. Block of coal. That's what we were missing last time. Well, I know I done mined up enough coal and I made some blocks, I think. Check around here just a smidge. Maybe I didn't make a block after all. Okay, well, we got plenty of coal. Nine. And we needed a mushroom. And I know we got some of them. There we go. Actually, I'm going to use this mushroom. Doesn't really matter which one, but I've got twice as many of that one. Okay, so first off, let's make our block of coal. And I'm going to need my other 3 mana steel ingots. And a block of coal. And a mushroom. And what am I forgetting about? Block of coal, mushroom, stone, piece of stone. Okay, I happen to have one piece of stone. Time to cook up some more, it looks like. Okay, let's tap that. Get us one more piece of living rock. This will let us finish that quest, and that'll be nice, and that's why I want to go ahead and do it, even though what I really wanted to do today is work on this other thing. So, you know, we just spend too much time watching this thing, waiting for the moment, then we got to throw this in, and real quick, whoop, nope, too late, missed it. There we go. Yeah, see, it's kind of a hassle. It doesn't take hours or nothing, but it's kind of a hassle. Okay, let's see, for our quest book here, that's going to give us natural magics. We did our runic altar. We made each kind of ruin. It's going to give us 5 of each, so that's pretty sweet, and that's why I wanted to finish that. And it's going to open up a ton of stuff. So let's see here. Not going to worry about those yet. I'll worry about these things later. Probably worry about that one pretty soon. But yeah, you know, I mentioned that this was making a fair bit. This went through 7 stacks of charcoal. Well, 7 stacks of charcoal darn near fills it. And that makes me pretty happy. But what we're going to do now, we're going to go ahead and automate this thing. And to do that, to begin with... Let's see, I was going to need... We came to this because we need a rune air for a Hopperhock. Hopper, okay. Plenty of them. Let's look at what else we need for a Hopperhock. We need a gray mana petal and a light gray mana petal, and a light gray and a gray regular petal. And we need this sucker, redstone petal. Well, that's a little trickier. We take a piece of grass, we take a piece of redstone. Oh, that isn't tricky at all, is it? Except for one thing, all the grass is purple slime now. Well, we got bone meal for a reason, don't we? And somewhere around here, I believe I got shears too. Yep, there we go. Okay, so we're just going to bone meal that, and oh, looky here. We're just going to save all these, because sooner or later we're going to need to make more of this stuff. Okay, so you get me. I put all my stuff over here, didn't I? Yep. Okay. Get me my redstone, piece of grass. There we go. And let's stick these in here. Now I'm going to need gray flour and light gray flour. And let's just break those up for petals. And I'm going to need to put one of each in the mana pool. There we go. And back we go to our altar. We're going to dump in our redstone root, gray mana petal, light gray mana petal, light gray petal, and a rune of air. Alright. And we're going to whack that. Hello. That's funny. Rune of air. There's our redstone thing. Light gray petal. Dark gray mana petal. And that's light and dark gray. Alright, I must be missing something. Let's see what we're missing. Okay. Gray petal. Gray mana petal. Light gray petal. Light gray mana petal. Oh, shoot. These go in the petal apothecary. I'm an idiot. I'm using the wrong tool. Like trying to drill holes with a hammer. Okay. Unfortunately, the only way to get this stuff out of here is by shift right clicking with an empty hand. And then, of course, your hand isn't empty anymore. Okay, well, we got our petal apothecary. It's all loaded and ready. So let's do that again. Rune of air, gray petal, gray mana petal, light gray petal, light gray mana petal, and a redstone root. And now we got to put a seed in there to make it all come together. That'll do. Yeah, I found a blaze farm. Happy, happy blaze farm. Alright. Seed. And there's our hopperhock. Ta-da. Okay, so that's one of the flowers we need. The other flower we're going to need is Daffomill. So let's go back out here to Functional Flora, Daffomill. We need another rune air, yellow mana petal, brown petal, white mana petal, and a white petal. And another redstone root. Yep, told you we were going to have more of them. Didn't expect it quite so soon, though. I thought somehow this didn't use it. Anyhow, so I'm going to have to tear apart a white flower, and a yellow flower, and a brown flower. Is that all of them? White, brown, yellow, and I need another rune of air. Yeah, they're popular here. Okay. Let me make it daytime just so nothing sneaks up on me here. I think I've pretty much made the place impenetrable, but I, you know, once burned, twice shy, and if you've been watching my my banished videos, then you know that lately I have developed kind of a thing about creepers. Because they've been developing a thing about me. Alright, there's our white mana petal. And I need a yellow mana petal. Whoops. There we go. Okay. And back up here we go. Refill the petal apothecary. Refill the bucket. Yellow mana petal. White mana petal. One brown petal. One yellow petal. One rune of air. Open that up. Get myself a piece of grass. And redstone plus grass gives me the redstone root. And let's drop that puppy in there. And if I was a little more organized, I would have brought the other seed with me. Well, sorry about that. Hello. Why didn't you work? What's in there? Okay, white mana petal. Uh-oh, I got two yellow petals in there, don't I? That's not what it's about. Nope, just the yellow mana petal, and I need the other white petal. I must have misclicked somehow. Grand. All right, let's see what we get out first. Redstone root. Rune of air. Yellow petal. Double check. Yep, now I just got to put the white petal in. White petal. Redstone root. One rune of air. And one brown petal. Oh, I got too many brown petals. How'd that happen? Okay, well, at least it's the last thing I put in. There we go. White petal, white mana petal, brown petal, yellow mana petal. That should do it. There we go. There's our Daffomill. Okay. I got some spare petals to put away here, so let me get that taken care of. And let me put away some of the other things that I'm not using just this second. I sure don't need that zombie meat. Okie doke. Let's see here. Don't really need the carpet, neither. Alright, so, got our Daffomill, got our Hopperhock. The next thing we're going to need to make is an hourglass. And that does not come under generating flora. That comes under natural apparatus. It's called a hovering hourglass. It's actually pretty easy to make. Now what we're going to need is 4 gold, 2 redstone, 2 mana glass, and 1 mana steel. Okay, well, I know I got 2 glass. And I'm going to need 4 gold. Well, lucky me, I've been getting some. And I'm going to need... Where'd my steel go? There we go. Just need 1 for this. Okay, so let's head on down to the mana pool. We're going to dump in a piece of iron. Gets us mana steel. Dump in 2 glass. Gets us mana glass. Okay. And then I think, have I got my redstone in? Let's get the redstone in. Double check the recipe. Gold in the corners, redstone on the sides. And open up our backpack. And mana steel in the middle. Well, that's interesting. Can't drag off the sides because it'll figure I'm putting it in that inventory there. Okay, there's our hovering hourglass. We are just about ready to begin now. But I'm going to need to pick up the runic altar. Okay, so let me get the runic altar. Now I've got a spare wand of the forest. And I've got a dispenser. I got some redstone repeaters and a redstone comparator, couple hoppers, an open crate, and some redstone torches. And we'll come back for the rest of this stuff a little bit later. Now, I mentioned this design. I saw it on a video by Riskable, so I just want to be real clear about that. This is not an original design. It's just a nice design. It is very tight. It is very straightforward. So we're going to start by putting this dispenser in here facing up. And we're going to give it a wand of the forest. Now on top of that, I'm going to put my runic altar. And next to that, I'm going to put, let me see, let's move the redstone down here. And I'm going to be using that, and I'm going to be using that real soon. Okay. So, we want... Redstone. a redstone repeater here. And I'm going to put that to 4 ticks. There we go. And over here, going to have our comparator. And that comparator is going to feed a piece of redstone. And then there's going to be a repeater going this way and a repeater going this way. And they don't need to be set to any particular ticks. And over here, going to put a piece of cobble. So this redstone's going into this piece of cobble. Now we're going to make kind of a stairway here. Yeah. And 3 bricks. And on each of these bricks, we're going to put us a redstone torch. This torch here in the middle is going to tell our dropper, or our open crate, which is going to be dropping stuff down onto this altar. It's going to be telling it to send out a signal that tells things like the Hopperhock not to pick stuff up immediately when the crate drops it. These two are going to be triggering our hoppers. So we want them to not go off when this goes off. We want this to stay on all the time, and we want these two to go off only when we tell them to. So we're going to put a dot of redstone there, dot of redstone there, dot of redstone here. We're going to put another cobble here, so that torch is not affected by this redstone. Alright, so far so good. Let me double check what's going on down here. Got my redstone, my repeater, this is in the corner. We're going to have another piece of cobble, again with a piece of redstone on it. And over here we're going to have another piece of cobble, again with a piece of redstone on it. Is there going to be room for that? I'm concerned. Okay, let me see how this pans out. I may need to fiddle with what I'm doing over here. We'll see. We'll see how it goes. Okay. So over here, going to have another chunk of redstone, or sorry, another chunk of cobble with a piece of redstone on it. And let's see here. I want my open crate in the middle so it can drop right down on the altar. And then we're going to have a hopper on this side feeding into the open crate. And this redstone torch will affect this hopper. And we're going to have another hopper over here, and this redstone torch will affect this hopper. Now, I'm going to need to grab a couple more items right quick. Okay, we're going to put a picture frame on this hopper. Now this is, you might remember, this is how you tell a hopper hawk what goes in that inventory. And a hopper is an inventory. And on this hopper, we want it to take redstone, living rock. Man, I got redstone on the brain now. Let's see, so we got the hopper, we got the item frame with the living rock. And right next to this, we're going to have, let's see here, where's my dirt? There's my dirt. We are going to have, that's not dirt. We're going to have a hopper hawk. And that is going to put in here living rock. And then over next to it, we are going to have another chest. I didn't bring any chests. That's because this is supposed to basically be my chests once I'm done with it. So let me just real quick take these. There we go. Come over here and put that chest right there. Okay. And the other chest is going to go on top of this. And this is going to be our input chest. Okay, it's night again. Pardon me, folks. Okey-doke. Right. Now, the hovering hourglass is going to be going, let me see, I'm pretty sure that the hovering hourglass goes right there, and that's going to trigger this redstone. Yeah, that's right, that makes sense. Okey-doke. And the other thing we're going to have is right over here, we are going to have our Daffomill. Let's see, we got that, one, two, yeah, have the Daffomill right there. Now, I can never figure out which way these things is blowing. Okay. Let's put something down and see what happens to it. Well, it's not blowing that way. Oh, but our Hopperhock grabbed it. Let me get rid of the Hopperhock real quick. Okay, I'm going to put down a piece of sand. Whoa, that was more than I meant to put down. There we go. Huh. Well, now I can't tell for sure. Oh, there it's doing it. Okay. That's doing it. Here we go. Watch this. Yeah, okay. So that's blowing it this way. Now I'm going to need to put another piece of cobble over here, and that's going to act as a backstop. What's going to happen is stuff is going to drop out of here, go into the altar. The altar is going to change it, then the altar spits up the rune. And we don't want that rune to be the next thing that's added in. So we want this it to be blown off to the side, and that's what this is going to do. But we don't want it to be blown so far the Hopperhock can't get it, so this is going to act as a backstop. It'll blow it a little distance, enough to keep it from dropping in here, but not so dang much that, you know, it can't be grabbed by the Hopperhock. Okay, there's our Hopperhock. Now, we're going to come over here. Oops, and I'm going to fall in the pig pen. Okay, let me see if I got this right. Okay. Oh, you know what? That's what I'm missing. That's exactly what I'm missing. Okay, so that's feeding in. That redstone's feeding into there. Then I've got a... Oh, this is going to make hash out of my thing over here. Darn it. Okay. Redstone. Redstone repeater. And this is going to be... I need a redstone torch on a piece of cobble over here. That's my problem. Okay, let's try this on. It's probably going to mess some things up, but... Okie doke. Whoops. Daffomill. Okay, that'll go that way. And get a redstone repeater going right there. Piece of cobble. Cobble. And then I'm going to have... I think that's messing with this. I'm just going to disassemble that for the time being. Torch. And that should turn off. Yeah. Now the redstone, now that's not blowing. I'm going to set this down. Whoops. Come on, pick it up. Set that down here, and if I break this... I forgot. Daffomill grabbed it. It means it got stuck in here. Oh, it's also picking up eggs and feathers. How lovely. Okay, anyhow, now it's working. Or it should be working. Well, I can see, like, the wind gusts and stuff. But I don't see... Huh. Oh, that's still on. Okay. How is that not coming on? Alright, I got my redstone repeater. Got my redstone here. Now that should be triggering that, Nope. It's not. Let's take you out. Now let's try. There it goes. Okie doke. Huh. Let me try giving that a signal here. There it goes. Now it's off. Except it's not off. What in the Sam Hill? Okay, that is working the way it should. Never mind. I'm easily confused. Let me just double check that other torch back there. Yep. Nope, that's the way it should work. Good. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna have to mess around some over here to make this part work again. Anyway. Alright, so that is dropping into there. That's going to there. Let's see here what I needs to have happen now. Got a lever. And that is gonna be... That is... That cobble gets redstone to link to here. And this turns off this hopper, which is feeding from this chest. And we got us lever here. And we can use that to turn it on or off depending on what we're doing. So now the trick we're going to need to do, pardon me, let me munch on something real quick. Toast sandwiches are kind of cheesy, but hey, what the heck. Alright, so that's going there, that's going there. We got all that, that's all linked in. How's that linking? Oh, that's linking to the bottom down here. That's right. Okay. If I'm doing this right. If I'm doing this right. Let's put one piece of sand. No, not 11. Ah, shoot. Okay, that was way too many. Where's my sand? Where's my hourglass? Oh, of course, it's in the chest where the hopperhock went. Except it isn't. Where's my hourglass? Oh, there it is. It's in the altar. How awesome. There we go. Okay. Let's put our hourglass. I'm going to put it over here, actually. And the reason for that is I still need to link this mana spreader. Get in bind mode, link it to there. Now, is that going to work? Or is that going to run into the hourglass? It is not going to run into the hourglass. Hot dog. Okay, now I put one piece of sand in the hourglass. Oh my god, is it doing what I think it's doing? Yeah, I didn't think that through real well, did I? Where's my fence? Oh, man. I know I got more fence. Oh, come on. I thought I had more fence. Okay, all right. I'm going to take this piece of fence right here. Dang. Because nothing can get in through that anyhow. And just to be sure, I'm going to replace it with a piece of netherrack fence. There we go. Okay, and now I have pigs and chickens every dang where. Let me take this piece of fence out too. Take out the doggone thingamajig here. Okay, put that in. I do beg your pardon, folks. This was not anticipated or planned for. Get myself that, and I need some carrots. Okay. And I'm going to put... There's my gate. Pardon me, Mr. Chicken. What? You get... I'll find you. Get over there. That'll work, too. Seeds. Come on, guys. Soup's on. Soup. Soup, soup. Soup. Okay, that works, too. Come here. You just get stuck. You're stuck. Okay. Where's Mother Chicken? Doggone it, chicken. Chicken. You're chicken. Hey, buddy. Wake up. Come on. Excellent. Okay, and that's two pigs in place. Alright, and I got another pig over there. And another pig over there. Okay, well, you know what? I can sort out... Oh, alright, fine. You come over here. How did he just... Oh, they can get in, but they can't get out now. Alright, I can deal with that. Okay, let's turn all this off for a second. That should be turning off this hopper. So now we'll be able to put stuff in it. So, what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to get the fixings of a couple of... Well, or at least one, because I didn't make enough iron earlier. All right, well, that's enough to do one. Let's see. One of them. One of them. And a feather. Let me get back over here. Basic stuff. Runic altar. Okay. Carpet, feather, string. Iron, carpet, feather. Gonna need to get the string. Okay. So there's that. Actually, I'm gonna give myself enough to do. Oh, I can't because I don't have enough iron. Okay, that's fine. We can still... Proof of concept. Proof of concept. That'll do it. Okay, there's our man of steel. So I'm going to come over here, and this switch, as long as that redstone is lit, I know that this switch right here is keeping that hopper from running. So I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, and then I'm going to put a piece of carpet and a feather and a string, and I'm going to go over to this other hopper over here, and I'm going to give this sucker some living rock. That's not turning off correct. Well, that's okay, because all that's going to happen is that that living rock is going to get picked up by the Hopperhock sooner or later. Anyhow, let's turn this on and watch. Oh, look at this. Ooh, looky, looky. I'm not doing nothing. I don't have to do nothing. Come on. Is it working? Hmm. Okay, whatever should be making the wand click for the dispenser down underneath ain't quite working right. So let's investigate. Things went okay right up to that point. Ah, okay, it just did the thing. In that case, over here, yeah, there's our runes of air. Hot dang. Oh, I see what happened. Oh, I bet I know what happened. Let's see how our Hopperhock is set. Pick up only items in frames. That's not what we want it to do. Oh, we're in bind mode. There, function mode. Pick up only items not in frames. Pick up any items. That's what we want. There we go. Okay. Alright, I'm going to take just a couple minutes. I know we're at 42 minutes. Mr. Chicken, why are you out here? I thought I settled all your hash. Come here. Come here. Good boy. How the hell did you get out? Okay, I don't even know. Anyway, I'm gonna come over here and I'm gonna grab myself some iron. Try to make this quick. 2, 3, 4. Okay. And I'm going to turn off that switch again. There. Why the hell is it picking up a feather? Okay. That was odd. I don't know why it picked up the feather there. It should only put living rock in that hopper. And it should keep picking it up and putting it back in every so often. Anyway, alright, let's get up here. Put the dang carrots away. Stupid chickens. Okay, there's my iron. There's my other iron. There's my man of steel. Okay. So since this is turned on, this hopper is stopped. Now when you got a chest over a hopper, it goes left to right, left to right, left to right. So we put three of these. We put a feather. And I left my other stuff over here because I'm an idiot. And the other piece of carpet. There we go. Feather. Piece of string, piece of carpet. Now, if we did this right, oh shoot, there's an egg in there. Oh, this ain't gonna work. Turn it off. How is it putting eggs in there? Oh, because the Hopperhawk is... How is the Hopperhawk putting eggs in that? Okay, I'm going to have to think about how that's working. Let's try one more time. String. One feather. Where'd the other thing go? Oh, it's inside the hopper. That'll work. Okay. Turning it on. There it goes. Huh. Seems like it ought to be done by now. It's not done. See, the timer's still running. It just takes a while and I'm impatient. There it goes. And I was standing here so the rune of air got blown right to me by the Daffomill. That was a mistake. Okay. Well, it's not perfect. And I still have runaway chickens, and I don't understand why, because there's fence all through here. How the heck are they getting out if there's fence all through there? Okay, I'll resolve that later. Anyway, now I've got an automated thingy that can make any kind of ruins I need, and that's going to be real helpful going... I just saw another one get out. Did you see that? He just kind of waltzed right through the fence like it wasn't there. Okay, that's weird. Alright, that's enough of that. Ain't gonna mess with it. Y'all have a great day. Thanks for stopping in. Sorry all it did is get this one thing going, but hey, it's automated ruin making in Botania. Woot, woot. Once again, I have to thank Riskable. It's Riskable's design. Y'all have a great day, and tell all your friends. Cake's good for you.